What are you doing?
Making a tutorial?
Yeah? A tutorial for what?
Native American
costume.
Tutorial?
Yeah. Well, here's a real Native American costume tutorial.
I think it's time for our next step.
All right, so the next part of this tutorial is researching the perfect Native American costume. So why don't you start with this video?
Hey, it's me. So as you can tell from the title, this is a Native American costume tutorial from a real Native American.
So first, the materials that you're going to need are a laptop or phone, an open mind, and the ability to look at the big picture. So I have a lot of information in this video for you, so let's get started. So in this tutorial, we're going to be answering some tag questions that were developed by a team of Native YouTubers. I'll be linking their videos with the tag questions in the description box as they come out. I think I might be the first at this moment of filming. I think I might be the first to make one. But you, in the future, if you are a Native YouTuber, please answer these tag questions and let me know so I can watch it. I'd love to see it. Also, this video is inspired by Homana Suktioma, so go check her out. So yes, anyway, this tutorial gets very in-depth, so I'm going to go ahead and switch to voiceover.
So this tag, developed by Susie Hyde Alive, is about Native American costumes, and there are 12 questions in total. The first question is, what culture, tribe, band, or nation do you come from? I come from the Anishinaabek, more specifically the Ojibwe. I'm a member of the Gnojikaning band, federally known as Bay Mills. According to your culture, how are Native American costumes inaccurate? So, costumes are often very skimpy, and they never have an accurate length or overall shape. They're also missing two main things. So the first is incredible detail that went into forming clothing. We use shells, quills, fringe, beads, dentalium, stones, teeth, bones, antlers. We Anishinaabekwayak love detail and pretty designs, and we always have, even before we traded with Europeans. But costume designs are very basic and pretty insulting. And two, a second thing, costumes try to mimic our traditional dress, which is not only not how we dress nowadays, but it's also insulting to see our ancestors who did wear this clothing disrespected on Halloween. Also, headdresses. Headdresses are way too common among costumes, and there are several reasons not to wear them, and some of them cut deep. First, only a handful of cultures wore the headdress that's commonly mimicked. In fact, I'm Ojibwe, and we didn't even wear those kind of headdresses, yet people put them on and pretend to be Chippewa. Second, the meaning of the headdress and the cultures that do use them is very, very deep, and it's incredibly racist to put one on. In fact, it's stolen valor. Headdresses had to be earned. Sure, you might see Navy girl costumes or Air Force babe costumes, but when the costume comes off, the Navy and the Air Force are still regarded with respect, and therefore are not tarnished by said costumes. Whereas our Ogichidog, our warriors, and our cultural practices are tarnished by fake headdresses. So much so that a chief wore his to the Supreme Court in Washington, D.C. and was told to take it off because no hats were allowed in the courtroom. Non-natives don't view headdresses as legitimate political markers, and Becky pretending to be chief isn't helping. Oh, and it's also worth noting that the costume I wore for this video has leopard print on it. Spotted leopards aren't even on this continent. What type of harm do Native American costumes cause? Native costumes are stereotypes. Stereotypes can be both good and bad, but even the good stereotypes can qualify as benevolent racism and have negative outcomes. There are other people who will be doing this tag, and I suspect that they will talk about MMIWG, which is an epidemic that is caused by several factors, both directly and indirectly, and stereotyping is a factor. In fact, costumes are actually another product of stereotyping and fetishization that can be aligned with MMIWG. I can give a more in-depth explanation on the connection between stereotyping and MMIWG in another video if you'd like, because that could be an entire video. I'm not a professional, but I'm about to graduate with a degree in psych, and I have a good understanding of the concept. Whether you want to listen to someone without a PhD is up to you. Just know, you don't need to have a PhD to understand stereotyping. Ignorant assholes are awarded PhDs all the time, and degrees are colonial anyways, okay? But in this video, I want to touch on the harm these stereotypes do and have done to our practices, not just spiritual practices, but our medicines and overall way of life. Basically, our practices have been, thank you, Allie W., for teaching me this perfect word, they've been bastardized. That is a loaded word that involves several concepts, but basically our practices are not viewed as legitimate or worth respecting. They're viewed as lesser than compared to dominating ideologies, and also viewed as playthings. That's why costumes are offensive, and corporations selling sage and Nikita dumbass dragon burning sage is offensive, because these are not playthings. The same people that call us sensitive or tell us to get over it get upset if you disrespect their monuments or swear in church. The amount of uproar that occurred when Notre Dame burned down is less than the amount of bastardizing of our cultures and spiritual practices. Don't believe me right now? Look at how people treat voodoo. Oh, but Greek mythology gets a pass. I wonder why. Share a story about a time you saw a Native American costume and how it made you feel. I won't name names, but someone close to me who is non-Native wore a costume one year, and I could tell they weren't comfortable with it, or maybe they weren't comfortable wearing it around me. But at the time, I told them I didn't care, but I did. Strangely, I wasn't even angry with them. I was just hurt. I'm not sure if they watch my videos, but if you're watching, I guess the cat is out of the bag. I still love you very much, but that shit hurt, and later on when I told you to burn it, I wasn't joking. Share one historical fact about Matoka and her real history. Matoka, or Pocahontas, was renamed Rebecca. Not only was she kidnapped, raped, and murdered, and has had several false and commodified stories written about her, but her identity was taken from her. We may know her true story now, and even those who only know John Smith's or Disney's story know her as Pocahontas. But she died alone, knowing herself as Rebecca. She had to learn English, convert to Christianity, and never seen her family again. This later happened to all of us through the boarding school era. So, now next time you ask a Native person why their name is in English, or French, or whatever, think about Pocahontas being forced to adopt Rebecca. Find a tutorial on YouTube and link it below and have other Natives comment on that video's comment section the links to your video doing this tag. I'm not sure how well this will work actually. YouTube actually automatically hides replies that it thinks are spam, and links can be considered spam by YouTube. I've actually had a few comments withheld by YouTube for me to review, and they were both links. But if you search for costume tutorials, there are so many, and they have a lot of views. I think that if you really want to promote videos like this in a comment section, it would be more worthwhile to actually type out the channel name of the video you want to promote and say, go watch so-and-so's channel. They have an informative video on why you shouldn't wear these costumes. That way your comment doesn't get flagged and hidden, and you can still promote the video. Also, YouTube recently rolled out a feature that hides comments that are potentially offensive for review. So if you go to comment this, probably don't include offensive words in it. What does your culture's traditional regalia look like? How does it feel that others dress up as Native? Well, it's not necessarily the inaccuracy of costumes that hurt us, though it is a factor, but there are so many variations. Typically, Ojibwe wore leather, often deerskin, But different leathers were used for different products, such as summer or winter clothing, summer or winter moccasins. What I've seen myself the most is women wearing a long buckskin dress, and men wore buckskin shirts and pants. People often view tribal designs as geometric designs, which were developed by other tribes. We have been using geometrics, but most of our work has been floral designs. I speak in present tense because these practices continue in today. The only reason, however, they continue in today is because parts of our communities passed them down in secret. We were beaten and killed for being ourselves, and our spiritual practices were illegal until 1978. So when I see others dressing up and cheapening and commodifying our practices and our clothing, it really is a direct slap in the face because y'all literally told my people they weren't allowed to do these things and killed them because they did these things. Now you want to rip it off and use it for yourself? Not only that, but I barely knew how to answer this question. Not because I'm not connected to my people or I'm not an authentic native, but so much has been forgotten because of your rules that you conveniently lifted for yourselves. You want to honor us? Then stay away from it. How do you dress every day? This question reminds me of when I was a kid, walking down the road on the res. A vehicle pulls up and this older blonde lady was driving. She opens the window and stops me and asks me where the teepees are. This was in the late 90s. I later told my uncle about it, and he laughed because he said he was asked that one time too, and he sent them on this road that takes you to a tiny little town way out there, basically 20 minutes into the woods. All this, and Ojibwe didn't even live in teepees. I wear regular ass clothes. I live in a standard house with four walls. Even if history didn't happen the way that it did, and we were left alone, you really think we wouldn't have changed over time, developed new technologies? We already did those things. We didn't live the exact same way for thousands and thousands of years. So if you really want to be 100% accurate on Halloween, consider this. If I see any of you hoes wearing Native princess costumes at Halloween parties, I'm going to get drunk and fight you like a res girl since you want to be one. Share a piece of history about your culture that not many people know outside of your culture. Dreamcatchers have to be one of the most widely appropriated thefts that are now distributed across the world. Dreamcatchers originate in Ojibwe culture, and most people who are not Ojibwe don't truly understand the significance or the meaning behind them. You never see non-native sources state that they're Ojibwe. It's always Native American culture or American Indian culture. This is because non-natives view natives as one pan-indigenous tribe rather than hundreds of distinct nations. Think of Europe and its several different nations with different cultures. It's the same thing here, and I really want to stress the word nations. We are nations, just like England or Germany or France. How many indigenous tribes, bands, or cultures are in your country? Well, I live in colonial USA, and my tribe spans into Canada, but there are hundreds in the US, and there are thousands of indigenous groups around the world. My tribe, the Ojibwe, are actually one of the largest tribes on this continent, and we are broken up into several smaller bands, and my brand is actually pretty small compared to some other bands. Share a way that you can support or honor indigenous peoples besides dressing up as us for Halloween. Be an ally. Don't try to be a savior. Don't try to fix our situations. Participate, but don't take up space. Listen to us and let us make our own decisions. If we say you fucked up, own it. If there's a chance you can offer monetary support, by all means go for it, but don't act like a savior for it. Recognize that it is impossible for you to know and understand everything about us. One major thing I think allies often miss is the fact that we are different people, so allies won't impose their own beliefs or the dominant culture on us while they help, and that's not okay. What do you say to people who, for whatever reason, say it's okay for them to dress up because they're Native too? I ask them about who claims them. Any Native person would know how to answer that question. And in this video, I'm not going to tell you what that response would be because, well, fakes. People fake indigeneity all the time. You know how many times I've been told, well, my grandma was 100% Cherokee. This could be a whole video in itself too, but basically, no one can ever name their Cherokee grandma. She was most likely a family myth. DNA tests are inaccurate, and blood quantum is a colonial concept pushed on us and dogs. Several natives do believe in blood quantum because they believe if you're not at least 25% or 50% or hell, some even think if you have any familial background other than native, then you're not native. But what they don't know is supporting the use of blood quantum is indirectly supporting people like Elizabeth Warren, who claimed native based on some 1% quantum on a bogus DNA test. It also supports those who claim an unknown grandma or family member, like Cody Rance or Johnny Depp, because that small amount of blood is supposedly there. But being native is not necessarily about genealogy. It is somewhat, but it's mostly connection to community, culture, and lifestyle. Like I said, this could be an entire video on its own because it's complex and difficult to describe to somebody who doesn't inherently get it. But just know that if you don't know shit about the culture you claim, nor are you actively reconnecting to it, then back off the claims of being native. But for those who actually are native and are still okay with it, they just don't see the bigger picture. Sometimes people don't make mental connections between sociological systems, or they were unfortunately raised with a very colonized worldview. Sometimes natives are just trying to survive, and social issues like this just aren't on their radar. But it happens, and I don't quite understand what drives people to be like, oh, well, I think it's fine, so disregard the thousands of hurt people because I say it's okay and I speak for all of them. We are a group of people who can disagree on things, just like any other group. Recently, we encountered a Twitter user who claimed to be Indigenous and argued about costumes with several people who, in turn, questioned their indigeneity. It's possible they were lying, but things like this don't make me immediately question indigeneity because, well, even Custer had his scouts. The U.S. government recruited natives to spy on AIM. There's plenty more examples of natives straying from their community for the clout of their time. Although, it should be noted that back then, a lot of the times, natives were forced to scout or make decisions that don't serve their communities because they were literally being held at gunpoint. That sort of thing never ended, because nowadays, that could be equivalent to having resources withheld from us unless we play along with colonial bullshit. But, anyways, yes, many natives do support costumes and mascots, and in such cases, some of y'all need to come collect your cousins because they need to wash their ass.
So now that you have all the information, your next step in this tutorial is to never buy a Native American costume. And if you already have, burn it immediately.
So how was the tutorial? Did you follow the instructions? No one owns culture.
What?
Oh.